Alrighty. Hello there. It's been a while, huh? Here we are on Tuesday morning, October 29th, 2019 at 2:46 a.m. And down below, next to the willow tree, that bright star is Sirius. And up above, we have the Orion constellation. Anyway, tonight we're out playing with some new gear. This is a Canon EOS R. It's a full frame camera. And even though I love the 90D and I do like a crop sensor camera, well, it didn't have the in-camera digital zoom, so I thought we might get better results here with a full-frame camera, which hopefully has better low light. And I can shut that information off here. I wanted to keep it on there so we knew what we're using. Go back down here a bit and get Sirius in a shot. Okay. And at the moment we have a crop sensor lens on the Canon. It's the 17-55, and we are running 4K video at 30 frames a second. And when used 4K on the Canon R, I'll just call it an R. Their naming conventions just drives me nuts. Numbers and letters everywhere. But so in the Canon R, when you use 4K, it's a 1.8x crop. Now 1080p doesn't have the crop. Well, I don't know what'll happen when you use the a crop sensor lens. But we can't go in very far. Since the lens only goes up to 55, but now I was out earlier testing and I did put a video together, but it's quite boring. So there's Orion's belt. I really can't see Orion's nebula. Maybe if I had the 70-200, I don't know. But the one catty corner there to the left is Betelgeuse, Betelgeuse, whatever. And Rigel is one that's on the bottom right. Well, we're gonna have to zoom back out to see it. Here we go. Try to get her in focus. And it may be too grainy at the 20,000. Let's look again. Yeah, we have it at 20,000, but I mean, we could go lower if I can find the right controls here. The layout of the controls, the dials and switches and everything is so much different than the other Canons. I think it took me a good hour to figure out how to put it in a movie mode. It's quite different. But now that Orion is up, I wouldn't mind getting the other lens just to see how well it comes out. But before we do that, I'm going to switch us to 1080p just so we can see a difference. Okay, that's odd. It didn't let me go into 1080p 60, but it did let me go into 30 frames a second. And it may have to do because I have the EFS lens on there. Whoa! I don't know what that was. It was above the willow tree. Didn't look like a meteor, but we'll check it out when we go in. Okay, but anyway, like I said, I'm gonna change lenses and I'll be right back. Hang on now. Now we're back out with the Canon 70-200 lens. We're on 4K, so it does have that 1.8x crop. And we're at 70. And Orion's Nebula is not coming out as nice as I would like. But we can't go in any further than that. I don't know, maybe I'll eventually get a Canon 2X teleconverter. And zoomed in this far, I have a hard time figuring out where I am. Trying to get to the belt. Okay, that was it. And at this distance, we can't get the Horsehead Nebula. But late for Sirius. There we go. So Sirius is the brightest one down there at 70. Focus. Try to. And just play around with the different ISO speeds. And so we'll end up with Orion's Nebula. And we'll end up with Sirius down here going into the willow tree. I know it's been forever since I put up a video, but we haven't had very good weather or sky conditions over here. This morning, well, yesterday morning now, we woke up to a whole bunch of fog, and it was quite cold out. I think it's down in the 30s right now, too. Nearing freezing, but I may put a few pictures in here, too, and we'll just see how well all this comes out. And crossing some fingers and toes. And my toes are frozen, so. So are my hands. Oh my. Alrighty, so I'm gonna wave goodbye to you from up here in northeastern Ohio. That's in the United States and North America. And I hope you're all doing well. I've missed you guys. Alrighty, have a great Tuesday ahead now. It's 3:10 a.m. up here. Bye now. There are some odd noises out here. And I think it'd be wise if I go in.